So I want to talk about something sort of near and dear to my heart, and particularly for the dealers that are out there that are selling product today. Specifically, what I want to talk about is bill payment to the underserved marketplace today. This slide actually is a slide that for any of you that have been pitched prepaid debit products is probably very familiar to you, because this is a slide that most people have used as a reason to get into the prepaid debit market. It actually has worked in a reverse fashion for those folks, which is that the underserved community today has about 30 million households, okay, which equates to about 60 million people, which is about $2 million in purchasing power. And today, the potential for that power is that $2 trillion, and only 15% of that market has been penetrated by another electronic means outside of cash, which is to say that a lot of people spend a lot of money and a lot of time on a very small sliver of that space. 85% of this market today is using a cash or a cash equivalent product, and they use it exclusively, okay? So most of the folks are using cash at the point of sale. They're also up to 70% are using cash for bill payments. And so for any of you that are taking cash bill payments, say, in your store, you know that while this might not be core to what you're doing, and it may be an exception, you know that there's a lot of usage and a lot of drivers for that. Primarily, we're talking about a local and an urban footprint. The majority of these people do not have a credit card or do not want a credit card, and that's particularly important. Most of the people who are transacting this business want to do it in a physical location, and particularly one without bars, okay? Most of these folks also have a mobile phone, and there's been a huge convergence around that. So you'll actually find that there's better use of a mobile phone than a computer in this marketplace, okay? And one of the key drivers that we see is that there's actually higher adoption of smartphones today in the underserved market than there is in the banked market sector. So it's about 39% today that are using smartphones. So there's major adoption and penetration in the mobile space today for the underserved. And they're using that device as their primary financial vehicle, okay? Why is that important? Well, the key driver here is that there is a strong, strong demand for expedited bill payment in this space, okay? So just this year alone, 58 million adults admitted to not paying their bills on time. 34% of those folks and 15 million adults have used an expedited service in 2011 already, okay? Consumers spent $20 billion in 2009 just paying late fees in the credit card sector. So what you find is a group of folks that are looking to save late fees, but be able to pay their bills on time in what we call a just-in-time fashion. So the consumers who have used an expedited service avoided about $4.3 billion in late fees last year alone. So what do we see about this market? Well, 34% of those folks are repeats. They use an expedited service at least once a month. Okay, so why do you guys care about this? What's the key question for your group? Well, the first one is, can offering consumer bill payment options drive more foot traffic? And we'll come back to the answers here in a second. And if they do come in, does that foot traffic translate into incremental purchases or an increase of profitability? And then the third one is, can adding certain bill payment options bring consumers back into your store more than usual? So in terms of the answers, today 75% of the consumer base that purchases a phone at your store will walk back in to pay a bill if they're a cash paying consumer. So if I told you that you could sell a product today in your dealer segment that would force that person to come back on a monthly basis back into your store, you would in any case sell that product. Because typically you're handing over a handset to someone who has a credit card, they're walking out of your store, and you might see that person with an upgrade. In the cash paying demographic, it's quite different. You have multiple opportunities to convert that consumer, to sell them incremental purchases. And that's where the second part comes in. We've done consumer surveys and we've done a lot of market research on the cash paying demographic, and what we've found is that 1 in 4 of the people who use cash-based bill payment in your store will purchase some other accessory. The average of that transaction is about $25, and it's a pretty even mix between accessories and actual conversions of a plan, okay? So one in four are coming back. And then the last piece is that because those consumers, so to answer that third question, which was, can I get them in my store more often? So let's go back to the consumers and how many bill payments they're actually paying. The average consumer, again, is paying eight. They're coming in to pay you one. You have the ability to capture the other seven, or a very large majority of the other seven. And I'll talk about how we've accomplished that as a company. So what have we found the needs in the dealer space to be? And it comes down to four things. One is the need for profitable foot traffic. You guys know this as well as I do. Getting people to come back in your store and transact is tremendously beneficial. The profit that comes from a repeat consumer is tremendously higher than it would be for a one time where you're doing marketing. The second piece is the need for speed and integrated technological approach to those payments. So what you don't want to do is bring a consumer in that it's going to take you exponentially longer to transact that piece of business than it does for you to do anything else. The third is the need for easy settlement and reconciliation, right? You don't want it to be any different. Why should it be? It's the same transaction, it's the same consumer, it should be integrated in the same approach. And then the last piece is the need for a strong synergistic relationship. And all that means is that you want to integrate things as much as you can into the point of sale that you have or the way that you go about doing business. Okay, so in terms of number one, the need for profitable foot traffic, let me give you a quick example of how you can do that, how you can monetize things for those people walking in your store. If you're a dealer and you have an average of 25 doors, okay, so you have a 25 location corporate account, and you're doing 100 bill payment transactions a month, then what we're saying is that just on that alone, you're making about $300 a month off of those consumers that are coming in, which is pure profit at that point. And you're transacting that through an integrated point of sale. We're saying that one in four are actually buying something else, which is an average of $25 a piece, which is another $600. We're saying that if you can capture just two more bill payment transactions in that month, not only have you driven them through the store twice, you've also received fee revenue for doing that consumer. And so it equates to about $1,200 a month per store, or an annualized revenue benefit of about $375,000. That's a 25-store chain. In terms of speed and integration, obviously, Precash as a company and anybody else that's a payment vendor out there has to integrate it into the point of sale that you have. And so the way we've done that is we've taken real-time payments, we've integrated them into RQ4, and what you end up getting is a seamless transaction that takes tremendously less time than having two different systems. Okay, so that was a no-brainer for us. And then around easy settlement and reconciliation, obviously, everything that needs to settle through the same switch. And then the last one is just this strong relationship. And I think anybody that's here from a vendor perspective is trying to add more and more products into that RQ4 system. So in summary, we see the underserved market as a tremendous value add for you. I think most of the retailers that are here, the dealers that are here would agree that taking cash bill payment is a tremendous way to get consumers back into your store in a profitable way. And doing it through an integrated system like RQ, we feel like is a best practice. So thanks a lot.